What's the various ways these people have taken the mark and they don't even know it?
It's invisible. The only way you see it is like in the old hippie days with the black light. You shine a black light, you can see it.
If you haven't, go to davidhebner.tv, sign up right now.
You'll catch full interviews not only on L.A. Marzulli, but Russ Dizdar, Rob Skiba, and Irvin Baxter.
You'll find we have an original programming channel with special interview, talks about UFOs and Bible prophecy. It's the interviews I've done. You can catch the complete package there on davidhebner.tv. Let's just start from the very beginning. Do you believe that there is, are we in the days of the mark of the beast? Whether you believe it's a system or an actual mark, are we in those days, or are we kind of looking at it and it's in a far distance? What say you?
I believe strongly that we are in, very close to having a full-born system. So I think it's, it's already here. I think actually some people may have actually taken the mark knowingly, not maybe knowing it's the mark, but probably. But I want to dive into this before we get to the, Revelations 13, 16, and 17. I want to go over 15 because I think outside the box, and let me preface this with, I'm not saying I'm correct. One of my main purposes is, of course, as a vehicle of God's will. That's number right. one. But also to think. And here's my thought on 13, 15. The second beast was given power to give breath to the image of the first beast so that the image could speak and cause all who refuse to worship the image to be killed. Now, I'm emphasizing the word image because of AI. And what if the first beast was physical reality and the second was an artificial holographic representation of the first? And this AI was all powerful because we lost control, as an example. And unless you could take on the image, nothing could happen. I want to get into 16 and 17, but I want to give it back to you. But I'd like to, I'm a top-down analyst. You've known me for a few years now. I want to come in from that 35,000 feet and come all the way down because I think it will present a more, develop my argument better than just saying, yeah, I believe we're in that time frame. Because I can give you fact after fact after fact that kind of hones in like, oh, yeah, he's narrowing my thinking. Now, I want you to think expansively, but it's like, that's true, that's true, that's true. Yeah. Therefore, we're getting more close to a conclusion.
So, David, yes. So what you're saying is that in the physical, the first beast is manifested, the physical. The second beast is manifested, it's artificial intelligence, which we are in right now. Now, you mentioned that there's many people that have taken the mark already and don't even know it. What's the various ways these people have taken the mark and they don't even know it?
There's already the hand swipe thing with the chips. So we know the chips have been around for quite some time. And when the RFID tag came out, was put usually between the forefinger and the thumb, a few people did it, and they did it for convenience and to be hip or cool, the first one to do it, so they could enter their apartment building with the swipe of their hand. They could pay for something to swipe their hand. Certainly that lines up to my perception of what the mark could be. And there are people out there that have done that. There are newer versions where it is a tattoo type of situation where it is on the arm, usually at the wrist level.
Yeah.
And it is, it's invisible. The only way you see it is like in the old hippie days with the black light. You shine a black light, you can see it. Another way that's popped up recently is the QR code. I mean, QR codes have been around for a while, but what I'm saying recently is some of the Amazon stores, you cannot enter them unless you have a QR. Well, I'd say a QR is a code, is a mark of some type. And you could be a fully paid up member of Amazon Prime, but you haven't submitted all the information or data needed for you to get a QR code emailed or texted to you, because you have to have that before you enter the store. And this goes back to Revelation 13:15. So the AI, there's no one at the door. There's gates. And the gates open when the QR code is put up to the reader. So no QR code, you know, like a Subway. I mean, this isn't like new technology, but it's new for buying and selling food.
Yeah.
And go back to the magic potion days. There were some people that, you know, couldn't shop because of their circumstance. So,
yeah. David, we have to take a break, but when I come back, I'm going to ask you about these banks, about the failing of banks. Is that the beginning of this great reset, which the great reset is part of? You can't buy or sell. We're talking to David Morgan. We're talking about the mark of the beast. We're talking about the days which we're in now. Folks, it's happening. We must understand these times. Listen, we have the new End Times DVD. End Times Investigation. I have a lot of my friends on here, Lisa Haven, Michael Lake. I have Josh Peck, L.A. Marzulli, Stephen Bancroft. I mean, 8 hours of me investigating things like Satanism, demonic powers, Illuminati, New World Order, Antichrist, One World Religion, End Times Miracles, Bible Prophecy. Folks, let me tell you something. One day, what you're watching us on right now, it's called television, it's called social media, it's called the internet. They're going to turn that baby off. You need a hard asset. It's when all this stuff gets shut off, this is what you're going to be able to learn from and to understand. So I want you to text the word CHOSEN to 91999 or go to davidhebner.tv/order or call 844-806-0006.
How can people be a participant and help you bring the last evangelist story to the public?
Oh, thank you so much. Yeah, we set it up as the model like the Chosen, where you can go and donate. You can actually be the financier on it. You go to lastevangelist.com and you can donate. You can be an actor, you can be a producer, you can be, or just donate. Special thank you. The brand new DVD of Last Evangelist. You can get it right now. It's limited collector's edition. It's got the new episode on it, along with band videos with me and Michael Lake and Lisa Haven, Sheila Lazinski.
Hey everybody, David here. Now, if you're enjoying the show, would you please consider becoming a monthly partner? Help me bring God's word to a dying world. You know, they need to hear the truth. And your donation will help do that. Please text the word CHOSEN to 91999 or go to davidhebner.tv/give or call 844-806-0006. God bless you.
And please don't forget my new books that are out, True Power and End Times Investigation. And it's you can get all this stuff there at davidhebner.tv/order. Hey everybody, I am honored and blessed not to have just one new book out, but two new books. That's right, two new books. The first one is End Times Investigation. I deal with Hollywood mind control. I deal with demon portals, the alien-demon connection, astral projection, program multiples, satanic ritual abuse, and much, much more. The things that I talk about in Last Evangelist and on my shows, all my interviews I do, it's right here in this book, especially my life story. Also, True Power, how to access your true power in these last days, okay? It's a war manual for God's children. We need to learn the enemy's tactics and how to battle the enemy in these last days. Pick up a copy of this book. Just text the word CHOSEN to 91999, or you can go to davidhebner.tv/order, or you can simply call 844-806-0006.